Our project this week is building a cow fence. So we have 10 acres on Whidbey Island in Washington, but most of it is the thick brush, like you can barely walk through it. The area behind me is our septic drain field, so we can't run livestock across that, apparently, according to Google, because it'll compress the soil on top of it, and that would be a real big problem. So we decided to get a couple of heifers to, number one, breed for meat steers in the future, and number two, hopefully browse some of the shrubs and help us clear a little bit slowly on our land. We decided on Scottish Highland cows because they are supposedly one of the best. That's a Douglas that I'm making mad standing here. Supposedly they're one of the best breeds for foraging brush and doing pretty okay. I've read some stories of people having them and just feeding them their dead fallen leaves in fall and winter, and they can have up to 20% dead leaves and still be totally happy and healthy. Like, they're just really good foragers, so they fit with our land because we don't have a lot of grass for pasture grazing. Our other reasons for doing this: one, I've tried going vegetarian in the past. I was vegetarian for about 3 years, I think, and I got really, really sick, even though I was following all the recommendations for getting all the nutritional requirements and protein. I just got super sick, so sick that I had to be put on thyroid medication and I had to get blood draws and start eating meat again so I didn't get even worse. So for me personally, vegetarian diet just does not work for me. My body does not do well on it. So next best thing for that, I don't really personally, just me, I don't care for slaughterhouses. I think they're pretty awful. I don't like the idea of animals standing in line for hours or however long watching their friends and relatives be slaughtered and smelling everything going on while they wait there. I just don't like it. I know that's the only option for a lot of people, and that's totally okay. Just for us, we have some land now and we have the ability to. I would like to try raising our own meat so that I can give them a happy life, and whenever that time comes, they can go out happy and not even knowing what's coming first. So those are my reasons. For Van, my husband, he agrees, but he also, for him, it's the cost. Cost of meat has been going up. Constantly keeps going up. And quality: if we raise our own cattle, we know exactly what they're eating, we know how they're living, we know that our family is eating exactly what we want to be eating, and that those animals are happy while they're with us. So right now we're just starting out with two. We don't have that much land, we really have any pasture grazing. We're just fencing a small section at a time to start with, because the two that we're getting are only like a year and a half and a 5 month old. They're still little, so it gives us a little bit of time to fence as we go. We're fencing off a small area to start them in, and then we'll just keep fencing gradually, and then we'll have multiple pastures for rotation too. Because we're just starting out, our property doesn't have any fences. The land that we own was logged 70 years ago, and then since that time, in 70 years, it hasn't had any maintenance at all. Good or bad, it's just been doing what it does naturally. So we have a lot of work, even just to keep our forest healthy, like taking out the rotten trees and the dead trees and keeping the giant cedars that are 70 to 80 years old healthy, because we love those and we don't want to take those down. For our fence, we decided to go with T-posts with barbed and electric wire. I don't really like barbed wire because we do have a lot of deer here, but we're keeping it at 4.5 feet high, so supposedly the deer should be fine being able to hop over that and it doesn't interfere with them. Because normally, to have a garden here to keep the deer out of it, the fence has to be 8 feet tall or they'll just jump right over and eat it anyway. So 4.5 feet, I'm hoping the barb won't affect the deer at all. One other option that I see people go with sometimes for temporary, if you're trying to rotate or clear brush, is the temporary posts that are fiberglass or plastic with hot wire. And that might be okay, but we don't have a perimeter fence as a fallback in case they don't respect the temporary posts. So we're going with T-posts because at least we can still pull them out with a puller later if we do end up wanting to change the pasture location or set permanent wooden ones if we like it eventually. Side note, let me rephrase. When I said that we don't have a lot of land, I realize we are very lucky and we do have 10 acres to work with. Our issue currently is that most of it looks like this right now. We consider ourselves very fortunate to even have this amount of land right now, especially in the current market. In order for us to be able to have this land, we bought it raw with nothing on it, and we lived here in an RV for 2 years while we figured out how to build our house. And now our house has been built for about a year, and we're finally at a place where we can start working on our land. So really our main issue now is that, one, our land is overgrown, and another is that we have so many plans and things that we want to do. Like, we want to have a greenhouse, a chicken coop, we want a pole barn. All of this is long term in the future, but we're figuring out where we want everything to go, where we want our permanent infrastructure and our building layout to look like. So that's why we're a little uncertain about doing a permanent fence currently. Let's go.
It's 100.
You good?
we can find the 15.
Actually, it does look pretty close together, huh?
Guys, you're moving the posts.
Goodbye.
What?
It just means the wire will do this. On a rock, move it.
We did it! Oh, well, in one day. Not perfect, but not bad for a first time setting fence. Pretty good.
Yeah, but it'll make it closer. Okay. Done for the day.
Done. Day two is chainsawing, so we're just clearing out the brush and trees along the fence row to make sure nothing's touching it. Luchi does not like the noise that the chainsaw makes, so he's usually way off in the shade somewhere. I know you don't like it. You don't like it. Oh, I'm sorry. That's good though. Midas doesn't really care. He'll stand right next to us and we have to tell him to go away from the chainsaw. I'm not sure that he really understands that it could hurt him. You're so sweet though, bud. Yeah, you're so sweet. One of the main shrubs that we have here is called salal. It grows really fast and it spreads along the ground, so it's almost impossible to kill it. Hopefully the Scottish Highlands help us by grazing it down a little bit and making our jobs a little bit easier, but we'll find out. You can see around the edges here where we've just been mowing and hacking and cutting it. We've even been trying to dump our lawn clippings on it to try and smother it out, and it just comes right back. So hopefully running some cows through our property while we're slowly clearing it will also help by kind of stomping them out. We'll see. Experiment. The chainsaw that we have is an MS-251 wood boss. What are you doing? Hello, you're so cute. What's on your face? Got some tree. That's nice. In your eye. Yeah. Today is day three of Project Cow Fence, and we're taking a short pause because today is our first hay delivery. This is a totally new experience. I've only ever had horses. I grew up on a Tennessee walking horse farm. Never had cows, and Van has never had or been around any livestock. I lost my Appaloosa mare before we were together. So this is all new experience for him, and we're both gonna be learning a lot from these two new girls. So for our hay delivery today, we don't have a hay shed or anything to put it under yet. Apparently cows are a little less sensitive than horses as far as hay quality goes. So our only options were this carport that we got to store our wood and yard supplies in that we're working on, because we have a giant stack of sawmilled wood that we had to clear when we built our house. And it rains constantly here, so we got the carport to let some pieces of wood dry out at a time so we could work with them finally. And our only other option for storing hay so far until we build a hay shed is to use some of our scrap wood and stack it on the side of our driveway under a tarp. So that's what we're going to be doing for now until we can figure out where we want a permanent hay shed to go eventually and build it. And the cost of hay was one of the other things that we had to consider when we decided to get house. Since we don't have very much grazing pasture now, we will be having to feed a lot more hay than people with pasture do for a while. And then
Van forgot to take an allergy pill this morning, and he's allergic to everything, so he sneezes constantly. So this will be really fun for him.
Wow, your legs are so small. Oh, already have a cow. Don't need any more. Good job, bud. Keep up the good work.
Now, day three, we're pulling out all the random stuff that doesn't belong in the woods with the cows, like these tillers that the owners left on the property, and this random truck bed they left in the middle of the trees.
which is gonna be really hard to get out now. We're gonna have to have somebody come in and take it out for us because we have no way of moving it. All the golf balls, we pull out handfuls every time we work in a small section because the previous owner stood in the middle of the property and teed off and never went to collect them for 40 years. So we find golf balls every time we clean up, and we don't want the boys to choke on them because they think they're really fun to play with, but they're kind of throat-sized for them. Golf balls everywhere. Fun. And all the trash. Because apparently the previous owners also used this as their dumping ground. So we have a lot of cleaning up to do along with brush cutting. And this, I don't even know what this is. I think it's something that you pull behind a tractor to do. I don't know what it is. But yeah, we have no way of getting that out here either. Today's day 4, and today we are threading the wires and making the gate.
Because our gate handles came in. Oh, it's so hot, bud. We decided to do this on like the heat wave.
Heat warning. The 1 week we have a heat warning in Washington. We're building a fence.
Ow.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll just stay in here and spool it. That can be my job. Cause
yeah, just stay and hold it upright.
Oh, Jesus Christ. I carried this that far.
Okay.
Good.
Good. Ready.
Cool. Okay.
And just the fence unspool right now.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So the line is tied off on the insulator. There's our loop to hook our gate to, and then our line coming from the other side for the actual gate. Do you know any electrician stuff already?
A little bit.
Yeah. That kind of helps a little bit too. Mine would not look like this if I did it by myself.
Wow, looks good, babe. So aesthetic.
Okay, one string down, 3 more to go.
Let's go this way.
That's gonna change real fast. Oh, bud, you're gonna be so sorry. Yeah, oh man. It's gonna be his ears or his nose too, because his fur, so I think that's the only place he'll feel it. One of our corner insulators, the wire snapped when we put the line through it. I guess just from us tightening too much or something, but man's just doubling up the wiring for the corners now, just to make sure they don't break. Which way are you gonna swing it? In or out? Out?
Well, it has bushes here, so I think you could just
swing it out. That's a good idea, and then we can like use that to kind of herd him in when the trailer gets here.
Okay.
So handy, babe. My gate would look like shit if I did that.
Okay, go ahead.
That's it.
Yep, go ahead and roll more.
Looks beautiful. 2 hot strands done, 2 barbed to go. Oh, that's gonna be the tough one. I didn't have the camera rolling, but the boys just wildebeest stampeded through the finished bottom wire and ripped it down.
I guess it helped us tighten it a little bit more.
Yeah, they were helping. You could just cut the door and do it separately at the end, even if you wanted to.
I feel like it's better strength, just not cut.
Make it easier to tighten it up later, too, with that long strand to pull on.
Yeah.
Mm. Ow!
It's gonna be rough. Where is it at? Where is it connected?
Hmm? Oh. 1, 2, 3. Remember? Are you okay? Just put it on the inside and then wrap this on the outside.
All right. They are not getting out.
5 strands, 10 inches apart, so we're good. Okay.
This is an easy way to do this.
I know. Flip it up on a side and roll it, maybe?
That makes sense, babe.
Roll.
Ow, fuck me, God. Watch your leg.
Oh my God, that hurt. You ding dong, trying to make sure you don't get hurt. Bud?
No blood.
No blood? Jesus.
Find out.
You okay? That hurt? Okay. Good boy. Good boy, bud. You're not in trouble. You're gonna get hurt. Scared the poop out of me. He doesn't know what barbed wire is yet. Bending in the barbs. You can fit it through the hole and the handle. Good boy. It's too early for dinner. Too early.
I know. The boys have been doing really good about staying out of the fenced area now because they already know the word out, which is really useful. And they've been listening and kind of getting the idea, but Luchi just saw a squirrel and dove headfirst straight into the barbed wire. Face first. So that was pretty terrifying. Scared himself, scared me yelling at him. I think he's okay, he just left a bunch of hair on it. We were just trying to teach them to stay out now so that they don't have to go through getting shocked in order to know it, because we have a charger that's good for 10 acres and we're only fencing a tiny portion, so it's gonna be pretty strong if we touch it.
Almost, bud. Mom insisted we finish.
Oh, good boys. Oh, you're doing so good. Good boys. Wanna come? Go this way. No. Yep, yep, yep. This way. Oh, good boys. Good boys. Good boys. Good boy. Good job, bud.
Flies, huh? Is that your stomach? Did you see that?
Beautiful. Almost. I know, we're getting hungry too, bud. Almost. Almost. Not yet. I know, it sucks. I know, it sucks. Starving, huh?
I know. I'm starving.
Not yet. Almost. Almost done. Ooh, perfect. No, not yet.
Wow, looks really good.
Beautiful, babe. Not too bad for a first time fencing by ourselves. The hot wire got a little bit loose since the barbed wire pulled it so tight. We'll just have to retighten everything up again. Day 5, got some flagging tape to flag fence. So hopefully not only will it help the cows when they get here, but it will help Luchi and Midas too. We looked at that footage from him running into the barbed wire yesterday and they're doing really well staying out of it and like learning that it's a barrier, but when something exciting happens, it just completely goes out of his head that it exists and he goes straight into it. So hopefully this is a good reminder. Got a new sprinkler that's been running all morning. Got the pool fresh and cold in the shade today, but it's 90 degrees. And it's still not enough. He's dying, poor guy. Might have to cave in and do a full shave down on him, but he's just so cute with his lion mane. You doing okay, huh, bud? This is your kind of weather. You a little hot, but you've been taking sun naps all day. We also got some of these warning electric signs just because we weren't sure if it's the law that you have to have them in Washington State. I know some states it is, so we went ahead and got some. But we are only going to be putting them on the gate, which is there and is the front of our property. We're not putting them on the back row of the fence because if anyone were coming in from that side of the property, all that's back there is our woods and our personal trails through our woods, which we have had some problems with people trespassing on. Frankly, I would very much like to see them get shocked. I just tried to put extra in the places where it looks like Luchi has been diving through and anywhere that he's left hair. I just put a couple extra flags. Hopefully that helps. I don't know if it'll help the cows or the dogs, apparently. But that's what you do for horses, so worth a shot. Like I said, barbed wire is not ideal. I really don't like it, especially for wildlife. But it's kind of our best option right now, especially since it's going to be temporary for us. This is the most temporary that you can get while also still being dirty enough to hopefully keep the cows in since we don't have a perimeter fence. And then later on, we can pull out the posts and put in a permanent wooden fence in some of our other areas because we have plenty of wood to do it. But most of the rest of our property looks like this. Focus. So it's just gonna take us some time to be able to clear out at least a fence row for it. So yeah, not what I'd pick for a permanent fence, especially like in the side of the house yard, but pretty good just to get the cows in here and get them started, and then we can keep fencing after this. I feel like we're probably gonna be doing that forever. No, thank you. Guys, look, hot. Don't touch, hot. Got it? Okay. We have a Purina 30-13, which is a large protein lick. We have a mineral block plus selenium because Washington soil is deficient in selenium and it can cause a lot of problems for livestock here if we don't supplement it. And we tried putting them underneath a big tree, so hopefully it helps keep the rain off them a little bit so they don't wash away as fast.
Drink?
Okay. And then, how long did it take us? 5 days? Something like that. And the lovely ladies get here tomorrow morning. Oh my God, it's hot. It's hot, I told you. Oh, buddy. Maya's leave him alone. He's mad. Luchi, he didn't do it. Luchi touched the finch with his nose and screamed bloody murder and then turned around and saw Midas sniffing him and didn't know what happened and thought Midas did it and went after him. They never fight. Midas is 100% submissive and Luchi's the boss, so they never have any problems, ever. So that was a really rare occasion. Luchi just turned around ready to murder whatever it was. Oh, poor Midas. Didn't do nothing. Oh, you were just checking on your brother, got blamed for it. I know, poor guy. It's okay, bud. Yeah, it's hot. It's hot. What happened? What was that? You don't know yet? Oh. Still a little mad. Jiboy. And they're fine again.